But with these modern tools, Power Apps, Power BI, and Flow, you have the ability to reduce the integration cost and bring together these composable business applications that speak directly to the digital transformation needs of customers. That's the new way to frame what's happening with Office 365, Dynamics 365, the opportunity it represents for everyone here, and most importantly, how we can help transform customers and their digital transformation outcomes. I just want to give you a feel for this at work by picking Ecolabs, a customer that we've been working with, and they're into water management. And water management is perhaps one of those topics that is so important for our times. And they are looking to transform the business from the boiler room to the boardroom. They're using digital technology to be able to take their existing systems and build new systems to create this one feedback loop that allows them to change the outcomes around water management for their customers. And to give you a feel for how this is working and the technologies at use, I wanted to invite up on stage Steve Clayton, one of my colleagues. Steve?
Thanks, Satya. So like many of you, I started my day this morning with a cup of coffee. But did you know that cup of coffee took 55 gallons of water to produce? The shirt I'm wearing took 700 gallons of water to produce. And the cars that we all drive every day take a staggering 39,000 gallons of water to produce. So as Satya said, water is this incredible resource that's vital to life, but it's also a finite resource. So Ecolab are focused on preserving water and helping their customers preserve water. And what I'd like to show you today is that scenario from the boardroom to the boiler room, three different people inside of Ecolab and how they're using this digital technology, this fabric of digital information across their environment. So we'll start in the boardroom and talk about how the boardroom has access to real-time data. Then we'll take a look at the operations room and see how they can take action on that insight. And then we'll look at the customer success manager working at the customer site on behalf of Ecolab and see how this is one consistent joined up feedback loop. So let's start in the boardroom. This is the view that Ecolab, the board of directors has, or the people who run the company have, is a Power BI dashboard that presents them with real-time live insights from data across the organization. Site management, performance of the business, their retail performance, and also their operational performance. And we can see immediately that we have an issue here with one of our customer sites, with City Power, where our goal is to be at 85% utilization. We're currently at 87%. So this is where we can go directly from seeing that insight and be able to start down a path of taking immediate action based on that insight. So as we drill into the Power BI dashboard, we can now automatically see or immediately see where the issue is occurring. So we have an issue over here in the cooling tower, and we can see the impact of that down on this chart with the blue line where the quantity of water usage is going up. And immediately we can see, if we click on the dollar sign, how that's impacting the bottom line targets around consumption of water. So that's the view from the boardroom. Then we're going to switch into how can we take action based on this insight. So if we move over into the service alert that's automatically being created based on this issue, not a manual creation, an automatic process that takes insight from Azure IoT Suite, Cortana Intelligence, and combines that with Dynamics 365. So what we see here is the beginning of an automated process to create a work order to resolve this issue. It starts with, if I can draw your attention to the middle of the screen, resolving water alerts from a 3D Trezor sensor. And if I open this up, this is a knowledge base article. The Cortana Intelligence has recognized the issue, pulled this out of the Ecolab knowledge base, and presented it back to the customer operations manager, giving them some advice on the actions they should take in this type of instance. So the action that's suggested is to send a remote command to see if we can address the issue remotely. And we can do that directly here from the service issue. So if I choose to send command, use an Azure IoT suite, this is literally sending a command down to the Trezor sensor in that cooling tower to see if we can resolve the issue. It turns out that the probe is operating correctly, but there seems to be an issue that requires a manual inspection. So now we're going from this remote interrogation, this remote action, to a whole work order being created. So you can see, again, if I draw your attention to the middle of the screen, four things have happened. We've automatically assigned a field technician based on their expertise, based on the location, and based on the availability of the part that they have in their van to resolve this issue. We've also noticed that if we apply this part to that issue, then the amount of parts that we have in our system have been depleted. So we automatically replenish the order system. We take the knowledge base article, we send that directly down to the field technician, and we also schedule the work order. So that's gone from our boardroom into operations. Automatically, all of this process has been created. What was previously a set of phone calls, was previously maybe a set of faxes, was previously a set of emails, now an entirely automated process through combining Dynamics 365 with Azure IoT and the Cortana Intelligence Suite. And if we take a look at the schedule board for the operations that we've just scheduled, if I draw your attention to the item in red here, we can see that Jamie Redding is the person that's been assigned to this issue with City Power. That if we click on Jamie, we can see over on the map her immediate location. So we can track in real time how this issue is being addressed and where the field technician is. So it brings together this digital feedback loop from the boardroom into operations and down to the field technician. Now I'm going to move over and be the customer success manager. So I'm the person working on site on behalf of Ecolabs at City Power. And over here on my phone, on my iPhone, I can see a set of notifications has appeared on my phone. So I have a Wunderlist notification about this work order being created. I have an Outlook email, and I have a flow that's being kicked off because of this. So how did all of that happen? It happened because of the power of Microsoft Flow, a new tool in the armory for you guys as partners to go and build these digital applications on behalf of your customers. So the flow I have here that I can literally create on my mobile device says that when a record is updated in Dynamics 365 for the customer Ecolab, and it's a work order, that meets a set of conditions. If I open the conditions, it says when that work order is equal to critical, it will then kick off a set of actions. And this is where we take on the power of the Microsoft Graph that Satya talked about. So I'm going to send a critical email alert, send a push notification to my phone. I'm going to create a Wunderlist task. I'm a big fan of Wunderlist. And I'm also going to create an update in our SharePoint site for all of the customer success managers who monitor City Power. So we're taking information out of one digital system, in this case Dynamics 365, and then flowing it through a whole set of other operations, completing this digital feedback loop. The other thing I have on my phone as the customer success manager on site is this application. It gives me the same view of the same data that the field technician has, the same view that the customer operations has, and the same view that the boardroom has. So you can see I've got Power BI embed here. It's showing me the same KPIs that they were viewing in the boardroom. I can see the recent activity from that work order being created. And I can see the current events that are taking place at City Power, my customer. All of that created inside of Power Apps, just an incredible tool for you to be able to create applications on behalf of your customers. So let's take a quick look at Power Apps. If I move over to the PC, how do we build those types of powerful applications? So this is me in Power Apps on the PC, literally building the application. So this is a type of thing that you could work with a business analyst inside of an organization. It's a visual design environment that lets you create these incredibly powerful digital applications. So I'm in the middle of building my application right here, and you can see that I've got a couple of errors on this screen. And all I need to do is to wire my application up to Office 365. So if I click on Add Data Source, you can see I've got a bunch of data sources in here. I'm going to show you some of the other ones that we have available, though, a wide variety of data sources that we can connect to, whether it's Dynamics 365, Office 365, SharePoint, even things like Salesforce. So we've got the ability to create these connections into these multiple different systems. I'm going to choose to just add a connection to Office 365, and as that gets wired up, you see the application is completed, and my schedule appears in the events there. I click Run on that application, and it will run here on the PC the same way that it runs on the phone. So we've got this powerful ability to create these amazing applications that build this digital feedback loop. Speaking of the feedback loop, the final piece in this process, so we've seen the boardroom view, we've seen the customer operations view, the field technician view, we've seen the customer success manager on site. Finally, this is the dashboard using the same technology, the same data that the customer sees. So this is the dashboard that Ecolab presents to City Power, their customer. So it presents them with real-time access, the exact same information that everybody else is seeing across this entire feedback loop. So what we've seen here is the ability to build these end-to-end digital systems. And you could be, as a partner, a participant in all of this, you could build all of this system, or you could build pieces of this system. It represents huge opportunity across the entire digital feedback loop to bring these systems together in an intelligent way. Thanks. Back to you, Satya.
Thank you, Steve. So hopefully you get a feel for how customers like Ecolab are going about their digital transformation. It's no longer about one monolithic suite and its deployment. It is this continuous wiring and rewiring of the digital feedback loop. That's where the power of the cloud, the power of the graph, of the data in the cloud, underneath all of our applications and the tools like Power BI, Power Apps, and Flow come to bear.